Welcome to Comic Book Creation Live. It's Wednesday, New Comic Book Day. I'm talking to Kevin. He's got something to show me. What you got there?
Yeah, I'm laying out my pencils finally, man. I don't know if you can
see.
Let's
make this bigger here. Oh, wow. Look at that. I like the gun.
That's the scene where he sees Alba and he's like, drop whatever's in your hand or, and she hits the device and he seizes up.
That's nice.
It's going to be dope. It's going to be dope. Yo, and I got two new mannequins, two new dolls, whatever you want to call them.
Is one of them a baby Yoda?
Nah, man, nah. These joints are pretty fire. Pretty fire. These posable joints.
Nice. I got your other one right here.
I mean, come on, man. Look.
Oh, yeah, nice.
So, yeah, I'm going to use these a lot, man. I'm going to use these a ton. These are cool. Going to come in handy, man. How you feeling, man?
Really good. Maybe a little tired, but what else is new?
Yeah, tired is a way of life.
Are you feeling better from your illness?
Yeah, a little bit.
Dog looks so big. How did that dog get so big so quick? I don't get that one.
He looks huge, right?
I don't understand. Like, a puppy usually remains a puppy for a couple weeks. Yours just turned huge. Into a big...
Fucking huge.
A big dog.
I got him when he was 3 months, and now he's 4 months, and he just looks big, man.
He looks like he's like 6-7 months old.
No, but I mean, when you hold him, he's still like, on camera, baby. He looks humongous. Like, he in pictures, he looks huge. But in person, he's not that big.
Yeah, I guess that's the way I've always said it for that dog, for your dog, was that even that first picture,
he looks huge.
He looked like an adult. I was like, is that the father? You're like, no, that's him. But for some reason, he just looks like he's in his adult humongous. Frame.
Like,
in the photos.
Like, look at this. In this picture, he looks pretty big. Can you see that picture? Like, in this picture, he looks like he's pretty big. You know what I mean? Then we can't really see it, right? Oh, the brightness. I got to bring down the brightness.
That was maybe trick, he looks right? like a puppy to me still in that picture.
So that was the other day. So let me. I have a picture I took. What the hell? How do I get to my recent pictures? I feel like an old man trying to find a recent picture. All right, look. So this is him with the kids, right? He looks huge. He looks fucking big.
He does. He looks like he's already grown up, but I know he's still a puppy.
Yeah, but then you see him on me, and he looks tiny. Like, look how small he is on me.
Yeah.
Like that's today.
Well, that's the one I saw today, but still, that looks big to me. I was like, isn't that like his like full size that he's supposed to be?
Yo, he looks big in pictures, man. I can't explain it. He just looks big in pictures. Like this picture, he looks fully grown.
Yeah, for sure. He looks like the father in that one.
That's crazy. It's my man. It's my boy, man. It's my boy, man.
Primal Gamer is here. What's going on, buddy?
Primal, what's up?
Appreciate you being here. That one line kills me. For me.
That whole intro makes me happy as hell, man.
Yeah, it's so funny.
Yeah, I don't know if I should get on the iPad or continue drawing. I don't know which way I should go.
Whatever you feel like. Maybe like do a warm up where you do it on paper, and then maybe when you're happy with that, switch to colors.
Maybe.
I will show something. Let's see here. I was going to talk to you a little bit about merch for the past couple shows.
That's something to talk to you about, Owee.
And I never brought it up, but
like what you've been acting all week.
Like I want a hoodie. I want a hoodie really bad, but I also want t-shirts. I want to see if see what the Albatross artwork looks on a black sweatshirt.
Oh, fuck. Bro, I was looking for a piece of paper because I had a to-do list, right? Let me show you. So I was like, I got a to-do list. Where's that paper? So I got a new book, and I started writing everything I had to do, right? But I couldn't find that paper, and that paper was to have something on Monday for Mundo's t-shirt.
Oh yeah.
Totally forgot about that.
Like, man. I've had this up on the screen for a couple of weeks forgot to.
I didn't mean to cut you off, but it's been bothering me that I was like, I knew something's on that paper and I couldn't find what that paper was. So let me write this down because now I'm fucking up. All right, go ahead, man. I'm sorry.
And I think I was pretty much, I was just saying, I want to pull up my Albatross PNG artwork that you gave me and see what it looks like on a sweatshirt. Let's see. Is that it? No, it's not it. I should rename this file so I could find it better every time. I never know where it is. Do it the old-fashioned way.
Yo, what day do I need to give you, pass this to you in your hand by next week?
Well, we're going to somehow print them. Are we going to be able to make it to the office to print them like you wanted?
I don't know. I mean, I can just sign up and go there. You know what I mean? Whenever need be, and then that could be the day I hand it off. But what day does that have to be again?
Well, like by the 12th, by December 12th.
Nice.
Page or two. That'd be nice. Yeah. Let's see here.
It's guaranteed. Like, my thumbnail is crazy. My thumbnail is crazy, bro. I just don't know, like, you know how you make a thumbnail and it seems cool, but then you're like, you kind of end up changing it a little bit?
Sometimes that happens, but with this comic, I'm actually sticking with the thumbnails. I think my thumbnails are coming out so rad in this comic.
My thumbnail for this page is pretty sick,
bro. Like, I actually get a little, you know, I sometimes think the thumbnail's like better than the
it's crazy.
Sometimes
it's crazy. It's gonna be crazy. It's gonna be fun, man. It's gonna be fun. Gonna be fun.
All right, I'm still looking for this file. I'm such a knucklehead. Can't find this.
All right, so
PNG.
I said Mundo T graphic. Gotta do that. Page 7. Keep going with that. All right. So my to-do list for tomorrow, December 3rd, bro. I got a daily to-do list.
Think you need one.
Need one, man.
Keep it going.
You gotta hold yourself accountable, man. If not, you just shit just keeps flying by the way, you know, perfect example, the way this just did. I swear I'm gonna do it. And the day comes, it's like, what are you talking about? I don't know. What did I say I was going to do? What are you talking about?
Yeah, there's like 1,000 things to do. That's why, you know, trading cards, posters, actual pages, script, t-shirts, sweatshirts, lots and lots of stuff.
A lot. Give me one second. I'll be right back.
He makes a bunch of noise on his way out, doesn't he? It's a bunch of noise. Okay, I think I'm close. Almost got it. Albatross. No. That's not it either. No. I don't know if you guys can see what screen I'm on, but I'm actually just looking for a certain file for this shirt. It's in my computer somewhere. Kevin could probably get it to me quicker, but that's not how I do things. I do things the hard way. Is that it? No. Let's do a search. Computer's like awfully slow right now. Oh my god. teaser, thumbnail. Do you believe I'm still looking for this? I knew I should have pulled it up beforehand. Where is that damn thing?
You talking about the headline, the typeface?
Yeah, it's like on black and it's a clear background. It's nice and you know what? I should just grab it out of Photoshop. I probably have it open in a document already. Okay, screw that way. Let's try this way.
Man, oh man. I got too many windows open, man. It's pretty crazy.
Yeah, my computer's like all slow right now, too. I got to restart or something, unfortunately.
Yo, today I was getting so harassed by the 9-to-5, man. I wanted to tell him that, you know, I'm not really here for this.
You were getting harassed today, really?
It's like, yo, I'm not here for this.
What were they doing to you? Stop asking for too much.
Stop calling me for work. It's like, yo, listen, don't call me for work. Yo, did you see Mando yet or what?
No.
Oh, you are fucking up.
I've been busy minute to minute. Both my hands have been so busy and things haven't been going right, dude. I was up till 2 o'clock in the morning last night trying to do something that should have been done days before. Still didn't get done. This morning, fought with it. It still wasn't working right. Something for my lightsaber thing. I needed to ship it out. It wasn't working right. I had to work so hard. It was ridiculous. I was so upset. I was cursing up a storm, just saying I'm gonna quit this. This is terrible. This is a fucking living nightmare. What a day. My hands have been so busy. There hasn't been any time for anything, and nothing's going right. Everything's taking 60 times longer than it should. So,
yeah,
I'm a complete buffoon.
Yeah, I'm slow as hell, man. I just been fucked up. Been fucked up. It's pretty wild.
All right, how do we fucking okay? I feel like it's like amateur hour right now. I can't even do this. What this is unbelievable. Chow? Layer. Copy.
Freddy says that. What is this, amateur hour?
Yeah. Let's see if this works. Nope. Didn't work. Damn it, dude. How do I get this fucking file over here?
So tell me what you're trying to do. You're just trying to throw that.
I just
want to
get that fucking file into Illustrator so I can just see it on the damn shirt.
So on a black hoodie?
Yeah, and I got it open in Photoshop and it's not dragging over. So I have to actually find the file, I guess, and open it.
Hold on, I'm about to do it right now. Give me 3 minutes, bro.
In the meantime, every time I click, my computer's taking forever. I shut off my video to hope to gain some speed here. Let's see.
3 minutes. I just got a fucking hoodie.
Yeah, I want a hoodie. I want to make a nice, thick hoodie, a good t-shirt for the summer, have some options, maybe two different things. You could wear one. I could wear another. Get something for Mundo hoodie, to wear.
Hoodie is mandatory, though.
Because I also want to give, like, I was thinking about, I was out there training with Mike today. I was thinking, you know, I want to get Mike a nice hoodie. And then I'm thinking, he should just have an Albatross hoodie. Why would I get him any other hoodie? You know, so just get these fucking things going so I could get some people
Christmas,
some gifts.
Everybody should get fucking Albatross hoodies for Christmas. All
it might even be too late already, but I would love to try.
All right, got the hoodie. Now just the logo on it, or you want like a piece of
work? I don't know. Like I want to, you know, creativity, whatever you want, something on there. Maybe it's the mother. Maybe it's Motor Scotia. Maybe it's Nika. Maybe it's Mundo. Maybe it's the twins. Maybe it's the yin yang twin babies.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
That could be the front.
That's dope. The yin yang twins are dope.
I would love to see that in like your style, like inked.
Hell yeah, let's do it. I'm pretty fast inking on paper. You know, I'm faster on paper than I am digitally. I'm 90% sure of that.
I got an idea with this art.
You know what I'm saying? Because like, I think there's some like mental fuckery that goes on when you're on the iPad, where you know you can like experiment with every stroke, and then you know you have room to fuck up, so you just like dilly dally, and then you know, yo, I don't like that. Let me get it like this. When you're on papers, like the intent is different, bro. Like it's like, you know, I'm gonna lay this line down, and this is the fucking line. Like this is the line I'm laying down. That's it.
You're talking about for like laying out a piece in pencil or ink.
I'm saying like if you gave me a pencil piece on paper, I would be faster and more precise with ink and a crow quill,
right?
Rather than on the iPad. On the iPad, you get to fuck around too much, and I think it's almost.
I mean, it's great for the coloring. Like great fucking for the coloring, around is great for coloring.
Yeah, but inking, I think I would. I think I'm a little better on actual paper at this point. I couldn't say that last year. Oh, I could share. I should be able to share this fucking screen with you.
I'm like learning something new tonight. I'm learning that when I'm live and I open up Photoshop, it's all Greek to me. I can't understand anything in here and nothing's working right. And it's just because I'm on the spot, I guess. Because like when I'm alone, I'm a fucking master at this.
Yeah, let me share my fucking screen with you, man.
I'm trying to invert this fucking image. Oh, here we go. I found it.
Share screen. Can I share Photoshop? Oh, I can share Photoshop. Share. So I just do a quick, nothing major. I just do like a card on there.
I would like it like, I don't know if the actual shirt would be like bleed out the black into the shirt.
Yeah, yeah. So like what I'm
that would be awesome.
I'm thinking of hold on, let me just rasterize this, get my eraser right.
Maybe the albatross text would kind of have to be at the top for a shirt, because it could be like it could go away, you know. It could.
So like what I was thinking, you know, this is my new shit right here. Like I love doing nothing more than this. So, just like running this on a sleeve.
Oh yeah.
Albatross Junction, bow. Right.
I would like to see that on the sleeve, like all white though. Just like white, harsh, like a silk screen.
Yeah. You mean just like a stark white outline, no gradients?
Right, just like albatross text or outline, either solid or with an outline on there. Oh yeah, there you go.
I'm just this is gonna look like shit, but just to get the point across.
Yeah, just a concept of what a shirt could be.
And then this fucking thing here. I think this could be a tough t-shirt. Right.
I like it.
And then we got to get, you know, we got to get stupid with the silhouettes, bro. Got to get stupid with the silhouettes.
I can almost see like the guy on fire being a t-shirt or being a sweatshirt.
Just yeah, that'd be dope.
Burning up.
That would definitely be dope. Oh, yeah, this is what we're doing. This is what we're doing right here. How do I get this fucker in there, though? Come on, you bastard. Copy image. Paste. Get that right, though. do something fucking silly like this. Now I'm being all experimental and shit.
Hold on, I can't see anything. My computer's like so messed up right now. I have to wait for it to clear. Okay, now it's back.
Just kind of fill. I can see kind of filling a silhouette of an albatross with just random images. You know what I mean?
I like that.
Then you can put like another little fucking Albatross Junction here in a pocket. It's like right there above the pocket or some shit. Boom! I get another card. Where my card's at, man? Where my card's at? AJ cards. Oh, here we go, here we go, here we go. To do this.
Okay, pay no attention to the
man behind a green curtain.
Yeah. All right, check out this one. I mean, zoom in on that.
Hold on, I gotta move. Yeah, shit like that'll be fire. I like it.
Be like BOMAG walking around.
I like it. Yeah, why haven't we done like a photoshopping show?
I don't know.
Make sure to show people we're really pros at something.
You need to lead it, because I'm a doofus when it comes to I hit live button and I don't know how to do any of this stuff anymore. I forgot.
I think this would be fire. Boom! The man, the legend.
What's Boom. That in the very center?
Get this.
Oh, it's a Dybbuk.
Yeah. Oh, get this fuck walking over here like a beast. Get him over here on the side. Bow, just rearrange it.
I like the bird thing a lot.
I think that could be kind of dope.
You know what else it could be? It could be even simpler, where it's like that bird outline.
Yeah.
In a gloss or a black gloss.
It literally could just be that.
On a black shirt. That would actually be a symbol too of the darkness. Like a black bird on the black shirt. Maybe with the albatross logo there. That would maybe get the idea across that this world is cold. This world is dark.
Oh, wait a minute. You just reminded me. I just put something aside for shit just like this. For shit just like this. Definitely not going to find it now, though. Definitely not going to find it.
This is looking good. I like the albatross bird. I almost think like if you put something on the back of the sweatshirt, which is what I originally thinking of, it will get covered by the hood when the hood isn't worn.
Yeah.
So that's the not good thing about that.
That's no bueno.
But you know, it could be something like what I put together here, where it doesn't even have the character there. It just has the text.
Yeah, yeah,
that would work. That would work for me. I think. Why that would be the best thing for me, because like you can't really see, like maybe I could point my computer down a little bit, like you can't really see my chest that much. So if it was here, that would work. That'd be good.
Dope.
This would be good for like you know, for the giveaways or. Well, actually, no, because the arm thing. I don't know how I never saw a place that like offered to put stuff on the arm, but. I guess they have them now.
Yeah. I got the school. Remember, I got the school hoodies that way.
Oh, very cool.
Definitely.
Yeah, there's that opens up a lot of possibilities. Because what if it's like an albatross bird symbol, and it's like in white and it's small, like you know how Abercrombie has. What do they have? A moose or something? and like polo has a polo player. Like Albatross stuff could have this bird.
Oh, you want to like treat it like it's a real line and shit.
No, but I'm kind of thinking like it's white and it's smaller and it's like repeated up the arm. Like you ever have like a pair of like Kappa pants or
yeah. You're talking about so like
it has like the Kappa symbol over and over again.
Yeah. I don't know what you're saying.
Oh, now it looks like ice. That's cool. Now it looks like total ice. That's a great symbol.
That'd be cool.
Any of those that you just went through, I liked. Even that weird one looked like digital or looked. That one looked kind of like all scrambled.
This looks all like nuts.
We're seeing this through the hologram or something.
Looks all nuts. I would definitely wear that though. Maybe a little smaller. Like,
to be honest, I like it big, but that's probably harder to do or not printable.
No, they could print it. Just sort of just like that, with just that on the fucking truss on the sleeve. I would wear that every day.
I want a good high quality shirt.
You could even like change it to look like it's flying up. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I can do anything. My thing is, this is crazy.
Primal says, if you got any cyborg animal designs, people I think would wear that as a design. Yeah, like all of our animals in our world are kind of like cyborgs. That's how they're not extinct. Yeah, you know, like they're all like extinct kind of, but they are some cyborg animals running around. That would work. Kill or be killed.
Kill and be killed.
Kill and be killed.
That's the mantra of our world. Yeah. You fucking coined it. You fucking coined it, man.
I could see that kill and be killed as when it's on the black part of the shirt, it's white, and when it's over the bird, it's black. Depending on which part, you know how that's a little harder to do.
Yeah.
Like you do a little mask or you do a cutout Pathfinder type of deal.
This is looking too
it's going to get banned. People going to get stopped and frisked with this shirt.
Somebody are going to get hurt. Yeah. So like you got to like chill out when you're walking around with a sweater that says kill.
Primal says, I'm just saying that the Siberian tiger you showed me and that cyborg polar bear half and half face would look sick. Oh, yeah, I can see what you're saying. Like one of those like 80s, like white Siberian tiger type shirts, but with a cyborg or with a half and half like cyborg polar bear tiger. That would be a good trading card, too, I think. That'd be good. I was going through some of my Marvel style trading cards from the 90s today. I think we're gonna have to do like an episode where we go through those, because I have a whole binder full of them, and some of them were like painted, like it looked like Alex Ross style paintings of all the characters. Oh, cool. And then other sets were like actual comic book art, like Liefeld and Jim Lee X-Men art from some of the X-Men shows or some of the X-Men comics and some of the New Mutants comics, and it would have their information on the back. So that's what we always talk about.
Would have the characters information, you're saying?
Yeah.
Hell yeah. That's where it's at. I love that shit.
I didn't inspect really what the painterly ones had. Those were in like a different binder I had, but I've been moving books from one shelf to the new shelf that I made and stuff. So I was going through some of my comic stuff. I noticed, I was like, oh, I got all these cards. I know I got a whole nother box of those cards in a short box upstairs too. Like I have a short box full of like Marvel cards, whatever type of cards I got, like, you know, those Batman the movie cards, like Dick Tracy cards, like all that stuff from the 90s.
You got a bunch. Are they in good condition?
Yeah. Like, you know, it'd be cool one day if, like, if you were over here, we were both there going through some of that stuff. Because I bet you a lot of the comics and stuff I don't even remember owning.
Yeah, I don't remember any of them shits. There's a lot of shit I have, but I'm like, what? Like, why did I get this? It's pretty wild.
Now I kind of have a mixture at my house of stuff that's mine and stuff that's Dominic's. But at least I know, like, there's certain crates that are Dominic's. I didn't go in those, you know. I'm just dealing with my stuff for now. But, like, he has probably all the best stuff. I have, like, more random stuff. I was, like, more random. Plus, I got some stuff from, like, garage sales. So it wasn't all, like, new comics from the 90s. There was a lot of mixture of, you know, the ones that are not mint. You know, the ones you find at a garage sale that are, like, all ripped up and stuff. I have a lot of those, too. This is looking cool.
Yeah, I like it. I like it. I'm just looking for one more thing.
One more element?
Yeah, one more element. One more.
I like how you pay attention to the tags. Like that one on the bottom is like an albatross tag.
Yeah.
And in your old style shirts that you used to make in your, the ones you used to put up in the store, you always had a special tag.
Oh, yeah, it's necessary. It's necessary.
What's the flame felt?
It's going to make you laugh, man.
Flame on. I'm gone.
Flame on, sucker. Gonna be like a totem pole little minor totem pole story.
Is there gonna be like an icicle up top or something?
Nah, man.
See, like the evil Star Trek group that's from the other dimension, they have a sword going through the earth.
I saw that. I looked it up. I said it's pretty crazy.
This one could be like an icicle going through the skull. Uh-oh. Cradle to the grave.
So, like, it's kind of like, you know, you kill somebody, you die and burn.
Yeah. You know, holy shit, that's so interesting.
It'll make sense to someone who knows will know. You know what I mean?
Mundo would get it.
The whole thing is, you know, in this world, if you kill someone, you implode. That's like that's the only form of like policing they have in this world. So these icons kind of show that if you kill, you burn to death.
That's You'll it. Be killed.
And you can see like the X in the bird's eyes, right?
Yeah, I like that. That's a good touch. Especially with the other symbols that you got going on.
These little symbols would just be off to the side, like right here. Boom. Oh, you know what else is necessary.
I don't think I have that page. Do I have that page ready? I have this page, which is, or I'll show you.
Yo, you know what, man? I should go back to making t-shirts, man. I love doing this shit. I could do this shit all day. Like I could, this is the shit I could do for free. You know what I'm saying? You know, they say like something like, you know, get paid.
Well, you better, because you ain't getting paid for this shit.
I ain't getting paid for this shit. It's for free. I'm gonna pay for this shit, motherfucker.
A skull with an icicle mohawk would be cool.
That'd be dope.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking too. Yeah, an icicle mohawk. What's that top one? Blood?
It's like a blood drop. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's hot.
That's perfect. Save.
That is nice, man.
File, save, print.
I lock up.
I'll wear it next episode. How fast can you get it over here? You gonna screen print it yourself?
I like it a lot. So the only thing I would change would be,
you're gonna send away for the screens? Looks like you need like three screens for white, blue, and red.
Nah, it'll just be white and red. Like I wouldn't even do the blue.
I think that's too much with that logo there.
I think you kind of gotta like get it in there small.
I think you gotta make people look for it, like you did on the bottom, and then it's on the sleeve. That looked like enough.
You like it better on the bottom, like not in here.
Yeah, like the like for instance, where you had it, where it was like a tag on the bottom on the front pocket, and then on the sleeve. I imagined that could like kind of always be there, and then you could make other shirts where that image in the middle changes.
Yeah.
I would even wear one with the symbols, like blood to burn, the blood to burn series on the right side. Make that like on the back of a shirt. That might be cool, like bigger.
Oh, this stuff,
just that, like on the back of a t-shirt or something, maybe.
Yeah, that could be a whole nother shirt. I kind of want to come up with a bunch of icons that tell stories. Remember I was telling you about the Mundo one.
It makes sense because like people would
like,
you know,
pictographs. Well, I don't know what the
like carve something in a cave or something.
Yeah. So I want to come up with a bunch of those. I think it'd be funny. Not funny. I didn't even have it cool. So what designs do we have in mind? I really don't know. I mean, as far as you said, icicle mohawk, I was always talking to Ant about fire mohawks. Like people in this world have like upgrades to where like their hair, it's just fire, like flames, you know what I mean? So like there's no ice or no snow falling on them at all. Keeping them warm with their little hair and shit. That'd be pretty sick. It'll look sick too.
Sounds like they need fuel, but maybe they use like a future type fuel.
They could have fuel. They could definitely have fuel. Definitely.
A lot of people use it like the nuclear type fuel that I know we need something. Maybe it's that, or if it's making flame, maybe it's some kind of liquid fuel that they've got. They can make all that fire, like something to burn.
Yeah.
Or maybe it's a some kind of crystal or some kind of element that burns easier.
Or why can't it be like a LumiForge type shit?
Like electronic, like a hologram, or it's just...
Well, it's like it could be a heated hologram, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Something. It doesn't have to be like actual fire. It could look like fire. It's like some sort of plasma.
All right, so let's maybe switch it up and move to your pencil pages if you're ready. I think I might switch to my pencils.
I'm about to set up my my little doll here.
What kind of pose?
Over the shoulder, like aiming the gun. Because you know how I like to have the panels, then I like the background of the whole page to kind of be one big panel as well.
Yeah.
So the top of the like the first panels I have are almost close to center. So on the space above them, I want to have him aiming at Alba in the distance, kind of just looking at him, her arm out, because he's yelling, you know, like drop whatever's in your hand before, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So I just want
to. Now I don't know if you need a. If you need a reference to what the gun looked like, I did draw it in a previous panel, but you don't have to.
Yeah. No.
You also don't have to make it look like since you're a different artist on that issue number two, you don't really have to make it look. I mean, you can. Yeah, like you could take a cue or two from it, but you don't have to be a slave to the way things exactly are because you know you're a totally different, you know, artist drawing it. So.
It's got to look a little similar.
Yeah,
little
like similar. It, like you could imagine, like if you were an artist on X-Men, and they had the costumes, like you got to keep the same costumes relatively, but you have your own flair, you know.
Yeah. Definitely, man. Definitely, man. Yeah. Just let me do this shite. Let me do this shite right here, man.
Now, are you? You went to full size on a comic book Bristol, or is that a Bristol that you put your own lines on? How are you doing it?
No, this is the Strathmore, the comic book Bristol, blue line.
So you have the like the blue lines there and all?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that's. Oh, now I can see it. Yep. Okay.
Yeah, man. Yo, he's looking pretty fireful though.
Yeah.
No, I'm not gonna lie. You know how hard that hand was to do? I erased that shit 47 times. I was like, hands are never easy. Just right out the gate for me. It's always a little bit of a struggle with hands. Always. It's fun though. Something fun about figuring out those planes.
There's also people like Liefeld. I was studying one of his Instagram posts the other day where he showed like the outline of Domino or one of his characters, I think it was a female. And then he showed it, an accelerated view of him inking it or penciling more of it. And the way it looked to me was like, it was imperfect. So there was like an outline of a female body and then like where her eyes were and where her hand was or whatever. But it wasn't perfect. But you know what he did? He just fucking finished it. What I mean? He just took it to the end, though. That was something to be said about that, I think,
Yeah, hell yeah. Just do it. Fucking do it,
like,
man.
I think that's how he operates, because it's like, he probably could have sat there and made it better as far as the skeleton of the thing, of the artwork. But I think it was fine. It's a comic book, so it's like he's taking liberties, and it's obviously he's like the number one dude. It's working, right? So
is he?
Well, I mean, I say he's the number one dude, but I could also say that about Todd McFarlane, about Jim Lee. I feel like there's a lot of people that you could put in that spot. I just feel like if you got the movie, if you got the rights to those characters and they're buying them to make the movie, and that makes you kind of one of the biggest dudes around, you've got like Deadpool and Cable and maybe an X-Force movie coming out or whatever. And I mean, he's the reason why they even had like a New Mutants movie, probably, is because he drew New Mutants and got them to be something back in the day, so they became something.
Yeah, it's true. Absolutely true, man. I agree. He's a fucking man. What's funny is I think it's kind of safe to say that, and it's not disrespectfully and shit, but like guys our age, like Liefeld was like, he was like second string. I don't know why, because I look back at his shit and I'm like, yo, his shit is fire. Like, he's dope. Like, some of his anatomy is weird. And that's even funny for me to say, because my anatomy is fucked up. My anatomy doesn't make sense for the most part. That's why I got these damn dolls.
But Liefeld always admitted that, those shortcomings. But I always thought the same thing. Like, back in the day, he was like second tier to me. He was like playing second fiddle to Jim Lee and
I think that's what
Todd
it was.
McFarlane.
Jim Lee was, and Todd was just top notch, and they were just like killing a game. So anyone else besides them to like an American boy was going to be like second string.
I also think in at least my childhood, it was kind of a game of, and my personality, where it's like, if you say you like yellow, I'll say I like purple. It's like, I'm going to be kind of disagreeable. So it was like Dominic loved Liefeld. So I felt like I had to.
For real?
Yeah. Like, that was his favorite.
Liefeld over everybody?
Yes. He liked Liefeld over everybody, even though he could see plainly that like Jim Lee had more skill. You know what I mean? Like, he could see that like Todd McFarlane probably was better at inking or something. But
you know what I think Todd McFarlane was better at? Intensity, bro.
How do you mean that? Like, number of lines? Like, number of lines in the artwork?
I mean, as far as like if he was drawing somebody crash landing, like, that shit was a heavy fucking crash, and you got all the little bits and pieces of shit flying all over the place. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like Jim Lee would have them crashing impactfully, but it would probably look cooler and more stylistic, like with like more like fucking like clothing and shit ripping and waving behind him and crazy capes. And fucking McFarlane was the man with capes, with Spawn and shit like that. But it's just as far as fucking shit up, man. I think like if you gave them all a Hulk fucking scene to do, I think
McFarlane would kill it the most.
Yeah, he might
have like the most garbage flying around. I kind of buy that, because I remember there was a few issues of Spider-Man where I feel like
fucking crazy.
McFarlane was like in his
Spider-Man's webs were crazy. I remember when
and also, like you're saying, all the garbage.
What is this?
all the New York City street. Like, he had that down. He understood that.
Yeah, it was crazy.
He understood that, like, you know what it was like to me, Kev? It reminded me of, even as a kid, of like a Where's Waldo. There was a few spreads in Spider-Man that reminded me of like Where's Waldo. There was so much stuff in the scene.
He was sick. And you know what I liked about Life? I like how Life felt drew, like, if the dude was a giant, he was fucking big for real. Like, he was just big. He was massive.
That's true. Like, his character, like, took up, like, the background, cable, I guess, like, so he didn't have to draw the background as much.
Sometimes I'll draw a cable. Cable would take up a whole fucking page. And I'm like, God damn, Cable is humongous. But it was dope. I liked it. I thought it was dope. Yo, who drew the Killing Joke? Fuck.
Was it Frank Miller? No?
I don't think it was Frank Miller that did the Killing Joke. Fuck. Well, that Joker's expression and hair always stood out to me too. Like, that shit got me back in the comic.
Was it Neil Adams?
I'm drawing a super blank.
Super. Look it up when you get a chance, because I want to know. It might have been Neil Adams. I don't know. He did Batman for a while. I don't remember.
No, I don't think Jim. Primer? What do you mean Jim Lee? Like, you're asking if Jim Lee did the Killing Joke? I doubt
that would have been before his time, because Jim Lee went over to DC. It was like in the early 2000s, but I think the Killing Joke. Yeah, was...
I'm just asking, like, why is Primal asking Jim Lee? I know he's not asking who Jim Lee is. Right? You just don't know. Like, I just you just don't know. I don't know. I need some clarification over here.
He's talked about Jim Lee before, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, right. I think so. I feel like Primal knows everything, man. I'm serious. I'm fucking serious. You know when Primal had me, when he posed that question about who would win between Spider-Man and I forgot who, and then he reminded us all that Spider-Man always holds back. And I was like, oh shit. Cause remember, there was a few times when, like, someone would run at Spider-Man and he would just flick him with his finger and they would go flying down like a city block.
Like, one of the things I really loved about Marvel Comics was those books, we've talked about them before, that had the power levels and the descriptions of the characters. It was like A to Z. It was like a Marvel A to Z in alphabetical order. You actually bought the issue that was like L through M or whatever.
Yeah.
Those are my favorite thing, to actually look at what Spider-Man could do. And he always surprised me when they said Spider-Man could lift 10 tons.
He said, no, I have no idea what that is. Yeah, Spider-Man was a beast. Like, he's catching cars and shit. You throw a car at him, he's going to catch that shit. That's crazy.
Yeah, if Jim Lee did any kind of Killing Joke, it must have been like a remake, because he came in after.
He didn't, though. Yeah, you know what's fun about penciling? Fucking just laying in, like, the true shapes of things before you, like, get loose and play with them.
Brian Bolland.
Oh, I think that is the name, isn't it? Yeah, I can see.
Alan Moore wrote it, and Brian Bolland drew it. 1988.
And I have this shit.
That would have been about 10 years or 12 or 14 years before Jim Lee went over to DC. But then, yeah, Jim Lee got to draw every character that is the most famous in the world. Like, he drew X-Men, Batman, Superman. Anything he wanted, he eventually got to do.
Yo, when they... I'm fucking up. I'm drawing over the bleed. Yo, when they formed Image Comics, what was one of their first... Like, what did they do first? I don't remember. I don't remember shit right now.
They did Youngblood was one of their first books. Jim Lee, and like everybody basically rolled out a book. So they went over there, and Todd McFarlane had Spawn immediately. He did Spawn. You know, he looked like Spider-Man. He had like artwork like Spider-Man, but he was a devil creature. And almost immediately, it's had a spinoff, like an HBO spinoff and a movie, like almost immediately. At the same time that Spawn came out as a comic book, Jim Lee introduced Wildcats.
Wildcats was a shit.
Yeah, and
Feral the Wildcat, or was Feral someplace else?
Feral was a New Mutant.
Wasn't Wildcats?
Yeah, I'm
Wildcats had like a little person who kind of led the team. He was a human being, but he was like a midget. And then it had
he had like a Captain America type of face mask, right? In silhouette, not in color.
That guy he was like the Captain America type of dude. Or was it did the small guy turn into him? I can't remember.
Yeah, it's a while, bro. We're talking years.
And at that same time as well, Liefeld came out with Youngblood. And then there was a bunch of other, like lots of books were started, you know, and Image became a company where people could go and actually own the rights to their own characters. But some of those books didn't really work out. Like after about 8 issues, Jim Lee stopped drawing Wildcats and he gave it to somebody else. He was just doing the cover. So you kind of get tricked into thinking, you know, it was Jim Lee artwork inside.
Yeah. That's not cool.
There was an artist, I can't remember the name, he was right around that same time, started at Image, and he had it was art like Jim Lee, and he had a comic called, was it Stormfront? It was another group of people, like a mutant group. You know, everyone kind of had something like that. But there was a few of them that I bought, and I bought that one. It's like called Storm something. It was kind of art, kind of like Jim Lee. I bought Wildcats. I bought Youngblood. I had all the issues of Spawn for a while. I was super into them. All those guys. Wildcats,
shit. Yeah, it was the best, man. I'm a once Image formed. And then I forgot where I was, but then I started like hearing about Dark Horse shit, and I was like, "Yo, Dark Horse is the shit."
Alan Moore looks like Dumbledore.
Yeah, he does.
Looks like Dumbledore.
Yes, he does. He damn sure does.
What is this that I have here? Huh? The wrong button. Ugh.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
What's the biggest Christmas gift your kids are getting this year, if you could say it out loud?
Yo, so I don't know what the biggest
one is. Or was it the dog? Is it the dog?
I fucking spazzed out, and I just like was just ordering shit without like tallying up. I don't know what I was going to.
Toys for them?
So like little man wants an Osmo shit, like an Osmo thing. It's like something you hook up to the iPad. It's like interactive. Mm-hmm. And then I got him some Switch games. Then I got him some other shit, and I was like, "What the fuck am I doing? Like, I'm dropping like between like 60 and a buck every time I press buy now." And I'm like, "What the fuck?" Like, so like their Christmas is gonna be amazing. Like, they're getting a lot of shit. They're just getting a lot of shit each. It's crazy.
Have you started like wrapping this stuff?
No. We just throw it in the closet because they're like they're not old enough to like snoop around. Like, you know, wherever they are. Like, they don't go off on their own yet. You know what I mean?
Right.
Like, they don't just hang out in the basement because they're bored. They stay next to us all day. So, like, we're just nothing really to worry about. Top 3 Marvel heroes. Top 3 Marvel heroes. That's, damn, man.
I'm going to have to say some weird ones. I like Longshot. I like Longshot for Marvel. I think he's a really interesting character. I like Jean Grey or all her iterations.
I think Jean Grey is definitely your favorite, period.
Yeah, because I've always loved telekinesis since she's the character that uses telekinesis
all the time. Do they have to be heroes or can they be characters?
I guess characters he must mean. Doesn't have to be a hero because everyone is like sometimes they turn bad. Like, you know, like Colossus was bad for a while. Like Jean Grey was the Dark Phoenix for all that time. So I guess they always, it's like wrestling. It's like WWE, you know, for a while it's like you got Hulk Hogan and he's the hero. And then Hulk Hogan leaves and comes back and he's the enemy now. He's like the bad guy of everybody. He's trash talking everybody, right? So it's like different, you know, like they, like the heroes would kind of come and go as bad guys too. Like Magneto was the biggest example.
Who am I?
I think all mine are X-Men. They're like Spider-Man might have to be in there. It might be like Longshot, Jean Grey, and Spider-Man. You can't not have Spider-Man.
Well, I mean, how are you not gonna have Wolverine? I know Wolverine is like oversaturated the market at this point, but I really have loved this fucking character my whole life. Like, I'm 43 years old. I've been a Wolverine fan since I was a kid, you know what I mean? Since I was a fucking child. Like, don't take it from me now, you know what I'm saying? But also, I've also had something for the Thing too. I used to like the Thing, man. The Thing was my shit. Like,
the Hulk was my thing throughout my, like, if you asked me as a kid, the Hulk would have come out of my mouth.
The Hulk was the shit, but Thing was my guy, man. Just because he felt like a New Yorker to me. Like, he was just like, you know, it was clobbering time and all that shit, all that stupid shit. And who else? Wolverine, the Thing. I don't know, man. There's so many fucking people, and I don't want to just pick the regular like Avenger types, even though I just said a fucking Thing and Wolverine. I was never into Doctor Strange. I never read a Doctor Strange book ever, I don't think. I used to watch Iron Man cartoon as a kid. That was one of the only cartoons with Spider-Man and Friends, Justice League, and then Iron Man.
Spider-Man and Friends was the shit.
Spider-Man and Friends was the shit. What was the name? Firestar or some shit.
Loved it. Loved the Iceman and all.
Iceman was the
everybody.
Shit.
I loved how their room kind of turned around. It's like, did they like live together, or Spider-Man would leave his house to go to their house and then it turned around into a fucking base? That shit was amazing.
I don't remember. I just remember Iceman kind of like flying through the window, like, and no one ever saw him and shit. I'm like, how's he
like,
just
did he live the there? Like, was that Firestar's apartment? I can't remember.
I think they kind of lived together.
What was Aunt May doing? Like, she
I think
got
they kind of lived together, bro. I'm not lying to you. I think they did.
I'm thinking like maybe like the two Firestar and Iceman maybe lived there, and Peter Parker would kind of come over and go into that base, or was that Peter Parker's house?
I think they lived together though. Honestly, I do think they like lived in the same like loft together or some shit.
That was the first Friends. Like they were friends before Friends, and it was even better because they were superheroes.
Yo, so yeah, I didn't say a third yet, man. I mean, I'm just going by childhood Kev, right? The people I've always followed. I've always followed Iron Man too. So like when Iron Man kind of set off the whole like good.
Oh, wow, I'm surprised that you liked Iron Man. Iron Man was the second rate character to me.
Nah, because they had the cartoon. So like, plus I got an older brother who loved the cartoon from the 60s and the 70s. You know what I'm saying? So he kind of like, you know, you see your older brother do some shit. You just like, yeah, I like this too. My older brother likes it. I like it. And I was a kid. So like that Iron Man cartoon used to come on once in the blue, and I used to watch that shit. It was sick. The way they showed him like in his suit. Did you remember that animation? It was sick.
I don't think I saw this cartoon.
This cartoon was old, bro. It was old as fuck. It was old. So I grew up with that cartoon and then Spider-Man and Friends.
I kind of vaguely remember being aware of it, but I don't think I saw that.
Yeah, man.
Like, do you remember there was an older like DC cartoon? It was like they had Super Friends, but then they had something even older. I didn't watch that older one. I forget.
They had Justice League.
Justice League was something. Yeah, something before. That was like, I felt like the animation wasn't as good, so I avoided it and stuff.
Like Super Friends and shit.
I like Super Friends. Super I thought Friends there was one thing I found.
When the twins activate.
I like that. I was down for that.
Yeah, that was dope. That was dope. I'm doing too much erasing here, man. It's pissing me off. It's like the figure looks stiff as hell. It's making me angry. Nice hand, though.
Well, erase all your problems because Mundo is here. What's going on, Mundo?
What's up? What's up?
What up, broski?
Little late.
Yo, Mundo. Primo just asked favorite top three Marvel superheroes.
Oh my god.
Wait, actually, let's start over 1 second. Sorry, Mundo. Let's do two sets of it. So, Mundo, when you say your answers, tell me like the one, like your top three from the comics, and then if they're different from the movie like universe, okay? Because I want to get your movie universe ones. I'm gonna give my movie universe ones because we're talking about the comics, but let's hear them both. Like, let's hear if they changed when the movies came out. You know.
Well, my automatic first two would be Spider-Man, but Wolverine, very top, hands down.
Hell yeah, Wolverine was the shit.
Wolverine and Spider-Man are top.
Two of the best characters to draw.
Yeah.
The best.
Those are my two all-time favorite characters of all. As far as a third goes, that would probably be a toss-up between probably Thor and the Hulk. Maybe Ooh. Hulk. Maybe Hulk.
Yeah, I liked Hulk. His cartoon was dope, but I used to lean towards the Thing as a kid.
Oh yeah?
Thing was my guy, man. I think cause Hulk, like, I had the reality show in my head, not the reality show, but the live action show in my head, and that fucking uh-huh. David Banner was so soft to me. I was like, yo, fuck that guy. Like, he pisses me off. Like, he made me so mad as a kid. I was like, yo, just Hulk out, bro. Like, just fuck it. Like, why you gotta wait to get punched in the face before you destroy this city?
Well, you know what I mean? Come on. As much destruction as the Hulk did.
I mean, but we're talking about a 6-year-old Kev thinking this, though. This is my 6-year-old brain.
No, yeah, of course. But I mean, you know, and later on, but when you think about it, how much power he really had, how much destruction he caused.
Yeah, he kills families. No one really breaks down the destruction left in his wake. he killed families, bro.
I mean, he even almost destroyed Thor's world. I mean,
he went crazy.
That was sweet how in the movie.
And you know, I'm sorry.
Well, I was just going to say how in the movie you got to see Hulk's room.
That was sick.
That was the best part of that.
I thought that was cool as shit because he was living it up, man. He was the king there. He was all like, I'm on my game, motherfuckers. Bring on the fight.
So what was the two-part question? You said comics and then movies, right? So those are your comics. How about the movies? Because, like, I lost respect for movie Wolverine. I was like, this ain't Wolverine.
Well, like, I gained respect for, like, Captain America in the movie.
Yeah. So, like, the movie Captain America made me think, yo, maybe I want to see some Captain books. I never really read Captain America books.
Yeah, Captain America's movies did really well. I was really impressed how they brought him out to the screen.
Yeah, it was pretty
sick. I mean, I never was much of a fan on the comic book. I know, because I just never got into him as much as the Wolverine and X-Men characters.
And to me, that like really happened with Thor. I wasn't understanding what Thor was like, or any. I didn't understand what Thor was until like the movie. I was like, I get it. Like that's what this is about.
Yeah, Thor is a real Norse god, man.
Pretty wild, man. Pretty wild.
Isn't it?
Pretty wild.
So, I love the movie, the Thor and the Hulk together.
I know.
That was great, man.
So I'm just having more and more flashbacks about like the comics I used to read. So I might have to retract because I used to hunt down Punisher comic books, man. Punisher was my I had stacks. I must have had like 150 Punisher comics. I had them all. I had war journals. I had them all. Mm-hmm. I had all that shit. I used to love Punisher. Punisher was my fucking. I love that dude, yo. It was crazy.
Oh man, they did him justice.
He might be. I might have to take Thing out because I didn't really care for Fantastic Four books. I just wanted to see like the Thing. You know what I mean? I just liked the way he looked.
Yeah. It's clobbering time.
Clobbering time. Yeah, it's clobbering time. So, I might have to take Punisher, man. Punisher, Iron Man was my guy, and Wolverine. But where was Moon Knight? Was Moon Knight Marvel or was Moon Knight DC?
Moon Knight was Marvel.
Moon Knight was dope too. Moon Knight was dope.
Did you know they're making some kind of Moon Knight series or movie?
Moon Knight.
I think isn't Netflix gonna take care of that?
Maybe you're right. Yeah.
Well, Netflix
Cloak and Dagger was dope too.
Oh, wow. Netflix did justice to Punisher.
Oh,
man.
Yeah, they killed it. They killed it. They
oh,
killed it.
My God. And the guy that played Shane in The Walking Dead, who plays the Punisher?
Yeah, he killed it.
Dude, he is just hands down the Punisher.
Yo, what about top villains? I know my ultimate favorite villain of all time right off the bat. Fucking Apocalypse was my guy.
Ooh.
In the comics, he was a shit.
Yeah.
Apocalypse was fun to read, bro.
Yeah, see, Iron Man was another one of those characters that I didn't really get till the movie. Like, I saw him as a C-level character, and then I never picked up the books. I just knew about it. I was like, okay, Tony Stark is Iron Man.
Yeah, and the old cartoon was like that. Shit, bro. The old cartoon painted Tony Stark like the same way they paint them now in the movies. Like they did it just, it was dope.
Wow,
they
made, really?
They made,
like the coolest man on earth. And then he would put on a suit, and the suit looked sick in a cartoon, and then he would just go kick ass. It was crazy. You remember that old ass cartoon? I'm talking about the old cartoon movie, the old
Yeah,
it was the best, man.
Was it like early 70s, right?
Yeah, yep. That, because there wasn't that many. There wasn't that many fucking cartoons. So I used to watch that shit with my brother. I thought that shit was magic. I was like, yo, this cartoon is magic. I gotta find it and send to Ann because this shit was sick.
Now that they have, well, it's not really new, but it's kind of new old. And it's Marvel, but it's kind of like a Jap animation version of the Iron Man. Oh, and it's pretty sick, man. It's pretty sick.
Whenever they would put out those movies, like let's say they're going to have a Doctor Strange movie or an Iron Man movie, they would always have a cartoon that came out like that had a similar story. You know, like me and Kevin kind of realized that, like they would come out with like it's like Doctor Strange is announced. It's like you could get that story like 6 months earlier in like this Marvel. It was almost like they would like test out the story in like a cartoon.
It's true. The Iron Man cartoon was done totally like Jack Kirby style. It was fire. I just sent you a link. Yeah. Check it out. Fire. What was that, Mundo? I mean to cut you off. You said who do I what?
Oh no, I was gonna say Jack Kirby was the shit, dude.
Jack Kirby was dope. Jack Kirby was dope. Hell yeah. Hell yeah.
He and Stan Lee made a fucking badass team, dude.
They were nuts. He said they were, what did he say? He said they would fucking make a comic in like 4 days or something crazy like that.
Mm-hmm.
It's fucked up. I heard that. I was like, what? But Kirby was a beast. He just wouldn't stop.
Well, that's why Stan Lee came up with a lot of storylines. And Kirby was the drawer and the artist and everything.
Yeah, his like mini documentary is dope. They have a few of them on YouTube. It's pretty dope. Pretty dope.
Yeah, they had a few creative differences, but then they worked them out, you know.
But Jack Kirby just sounds like he was just a cool fucking dude, man. Like,
right?
Sounds like he was real fucking cool.
I mean, because you could tell how much Stan Lee really admired him and, you know, respected him because of the way he talked about him, you know.
Yeah, and it sounds like you just leave him alone, like let him like go home for lunch, let him drink his beer, whatever the fuck he wanted, smoke his cigarettes, and he'll just stay there and draw for 19 hours if he had to.
Yep,
it's pretty crazy.
Yeah, but I mean, when it came down to him drawing and doing all of his shit, man, that was a beast, dude.
Yeah, he had his own everything. He had his own style. He was sick.
Let's check out this Iron Man intro.
Shit, bro. This is shit. Bro, this is gonna make you happy.
This was something that slipped by me.
It's gonna make you happy. Makes you feel he's the coolest guy with the heart of steel. Yo, that was the shit back then. And he was ruthless, bro. Like he wasn't friendly. He was no joke. It was a different time when they made that fucking cartoon, man. He was blowing shit up. Blowing shit up, bro. In that cartoon, he was blowing everything up. He was a beast.
That must have been the inspiration for the film.
Yeah, and it was cool as fuck, man. And then they had a couple of updates, like early, I think like either late 70s or early 80s, I'm not sure. They updated it a little bit, and it was like even fucking better. I was like, yo, this is amazing. I was like, this is fucking, like, how can you not watch this? This is incredible. Yeah, you know what's funny? I remember watching it in my bedroom, and I'm 4 years younger than my sister, right? So all the furniture in the room was like kind of like girly, like it was like white dresser drawers and shit like that, and it had Raggedy Ann and Andy on them. And I would sit on the floor, and like the Raggedy Ann fucking drawer set was like right in front of me, and they had like a cutout Raggedy Andy. And I would just look at Raggedy Andy at commercial breaks and shit, and sit down, look up at the TV. Iron Man came up. I'm fucking looking at
little fat boy,
little fat cat, man. It was the best, man. Those are the best days ever.
They would put that on for you, or that's what your sister's watching?
Well, I was just in the room. That's when I was just in the room. I was just in the room watching this shit while they were just doing whatever.
You were like they were babysitting you type of thing.
Yeah, I was in the room doing this, watching Iron Man. The best. The what? Oh, the box office artist is he's sick, bro. I haven't seen his Stan Lee tribute, but I watch him a lot. I caught wind of him when he did that whole like Star Wars piece that was ridiculous. Box office, right. He's fucked up, bro. He's nuts.
I don't know how he does it when he draws for like 24 hours or straight or whatever.
I don't know. I don't get it. He's just fucking good. I like when he makes everybody look like Marvel. Like he'll take taking Teletubbies and making them Marvel. It's like, what the fuck? Like, and then you see it and you're like, oh yeah, that is kind of Marvel. Yeah, he's dope. He's dope. Box office artist is sick.
Was that Iron Man thing is like the intro to the show, or that's what they played right before the commercial?
Oh.
The
intro to the show. Pretty wild, man. Pretty
Primal
wild.
Likes Venom, Joker, Red Hood. What does Red Hood do? Is that like a Batman enemy?
Yeah.
Favorite comic villains. Yeah. Is that actually Batman himself, or that's a Batman enemy?
I think it was a Batman enemy, no?
Okay. I'm confused about Red Hood.
I didn't really start reading Batman until later too, like until they started making all like after like Killing Joke and shit. I got that. And what's funny is about Batman, I don't buy Batman comics, but I would buy all the fucking graphic novels or all the collections. You know what I mean? Like, the collections were dope. Like, Hush. Remember, Hush was fucked up, bro. Hush was sick.
Oh, sorry, guys. I don't know what happened there. It just some reason. Yeah, no. For whatever reason, I was hitting the chat, and then I tried to get back, and it completely jumped out.
I don't think you ever hiccuped. I think I saw you the whole time.
No, really? I think I actually did it. I think like my finger hit a button and Mundo disappeared for a second.
I was like, what the fuck? Bro. I'm like, shit.
It's fucked up.
I think I gotta break open a new Strathmore.
Oh shit.
Oh my goodness.
Exciting times, man.
Hey, so did y'all see any of those episodes from that Marvel's Iron Man, but it's like the Jap animation series.
Nah.
Sounds so racist.
Jap
No, because it was the Japanese animation brought Iron Man, but they I don't know, it seems like it's like a lot better than the shit on the kids DX on Disney DX or whatever it is.
Yeah, that shit is terrible. Looks like a toy.
You know, yeah, no, but like the that. One that the Jap animation one makes it look pretty freaking badass, dude.
Yeah, I gotta check that out.
I'm gonna try to see if I can find
gotta check it. That out.
I think I have it in my computer. If I have it in the computer, I'll send you guys. I'll send you guys the series. Cause
oh, nice.
I'll send you all the series. Because they did Wolverine. They did Iron Man. They did I think Doctor Strange. I'll have to look at it. But there was a several that they did, man. And dude, the storylines, the drawing and everything is just wicked, wicked badass. Crisp lines. Excuse me. Crisp lines, and it just everything pops. Everything pops, dude.
Yeah, I gotta check that out. I definitely seen the Wolverine version. That looks pretty sick. It's like, are you talking about the style where they give him like big broad feet and shit like that? Skinny waist.
I think so because it'll say Marvel's Wolverine, but then underneath it's got like the Japanese characters and stuff.
Oh, all right.
I'm trying to see if I can find it on my iPad right now.
He was Jason Todd's.
He's brought back to life by the Lazarus Pit, and he goes mental due to Batman never killing Joker after he died. He uses pistols and knives and becomes lethal protector. Who's lethal protector? The Joker's protector? Or Batman's protector? He goes mental due to Batman never killing Joker after he died, and he uses pistols and knives.
Who used pistols and knives?
Red Hood.
Batman? Oh, Red Hood.
Sometime later, he helps Batman.
Yeah, I mean, because I saw the
killing. It's like a cartoon called, like, Under the Red Hood. I think I watched it, but I'm so dumb that I forget things, like, unless I watch it 100 times. Like, I've watched Star Wars 100 times, so I can remember every bit of it. But anything else, you know, it's not as retrievable in my memory.
Yeah.
Unless it's repetitive.
My God. Man, that's funny, dude. So, if I want to get something through to you, I got to do it like 100 times. Huh?
Just keep hitting them up.
Keep hitting. Don't feel bad. Don't feel bad. I'm the same way. So I'm just fucking with you. Why did it get so damn quiet? Jeez. My goodness. Let's not get lame in here now.
I'm here. I'm trying to
what are you all working on
for the first time in a long time?
What are you working on?
Issue 2 pencils.
2?
Yeah, man.
And what you got going down?
It was crazy.
I am looking for an image of the Concordia, which is this Donovan ship, because I need to draw the silhouette of that right again.
Oh, okay.
And I'm looking through my pages. I don't see. Where did some? Oh, maybe Kevin has those pages actually. So I have like newer pages and then like super old pages.
You want a screenshot of it?
Yeah, yeah, anything.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I'd buy that for $1.
You want the you want me to text it to you or email?
Text would be good, because then I could pull out my phone and kind of look at it while I draw this. I got an idea, kind of the way you would design a page, where I'm going to draw the Concordia silhouette taking up much of the page, like half, but then the panels that I draw will be laid on top of that.
All right.
So I think you'll be able to get that, like, oh, he's working on the Concordia.
Nice. So I got the top view silhouette, or you want the profile?
Top view.
All right. Yeah, I sent that to you just now.
Thank you. Oh, beautiful. Yeah, there we go. Kind of looks like Batman ship. It does.
All good. That shit is all good.
Looks like what Batman flew in front of the moon to make it look like the bat symbol.
That was the best. That was the coolest shit ever.
You can't beat that 1989 Batman.
Nah, that was a shit.
Yeah, like if I was changing my Marvel vote depending on the movie universe, I think I would have to change it up a bit. I don't like the way they handled Jean Grey in the movie universe so much. Or
yeah, I think they kind of made her a lot weaker than she should be.
Yeah. So I think in the movie universe, I like, you know, the people they were pushing hard, I think did turn out to be the coolest people, like Tony Stark and Captain America. You know, that were like, if you watch that Civil War movie, there's some maneuvers Captain America does. If you watch
Winter Soldier,
he does some kicks. I mean, he fights George St. Pierre. He does kicks. He throws a shield at people. He runs and kicks them. Then he catches the shield. It's amazing. Oh, yeah,
with the shield is sick, especially that opening scene of his own movie when he was running through the ship. That was crazy. Yes. That was insane, bro.
Loved it. Every bit of it, like even the corny stuff, like when they're like, "Oh, he jumped!" It's like, was he wearing a parachute? It's like, no. And then he just gets on the ship real quick and he jumps, kicks people, and even other special fighter, like even his own government is like working, kind of parallel but against him. Like, you know how they send like Scarlet Witch, and she's like. He's like, what are you doing? And she's like, I got a different mission than you. Like, I'm doing my fucking mission. You do your bullshit. You know, like, he's supposed to be, like, doing, like, heroic type shit. And she's, like, downloading files and, like, giving people viruses and stuff.
Scarlet Witch?
Yeah, yeah. Wasn't it that one? I think it was that one.
Look, here's a pic from that Iron Man series that I was telling you about, dude.
Oh, no, I've never seen that. That looks pretty sick. That looks good as hell.
Like, other than Iron Man looking like a total douche, it looks
very douchey, but it's all good. He does.
Like, if I had a robot suit like that, I would probably be even more of a dickhead than I am now.
I don't know why you would ever be home. Like, why would you ever be home if you had that shit? I wouldn't be home, bro. I'd be taking all types of trips, doing all
like,
types.
I guess you're home like he was. Remember, he was hanging out at home, drinking, having a party. So, like, if you're, like, throwing a party, you might be, like, passed out in your house. But, yeah, like, normally he's probably out and, like, at, like, Hollywood-type parties and stuff, probably. I don't know.
It's the fucking man. Dude's the fucking
Yeah, see how it has the Japanese characters underneath there? I don't know if you can see that or not.
I got to check that out, man. Yeah, I got to check it out.
I got it, man. I'll send it to you. I'll send you all the whole series.
Send him the torrent, the BitTorrent.
Oh, remember that? BitTorrents.
I got quite a few of them torrents.
Yeah, I used to be a BitTorrent killer.
Yeah, I do like...
No, see, like, I do it and kind of joke about it, but I don't know anything about it. Like
Pirate Bay and shit.
I literally just know the name of it. I don't know anything else.
Sure.
Because like my roommates would do that, and like I was paying the cable bill, and then the cable bill would come with a special letter, and it would say like, "You better cease and desist like your motherfucking actions, because like we're gonna come after your bitch ass because you've been downloading some BitTorrent crap."
I got this.
Like, what?
Yeah. So I were you downloading porn?
Like they were like, because it was Comcast, Kev. I don't know what your thing was, but ours was Comcast, and they're like, we have to pay like if you do it again, we have to pay all this money. And I was like,
what?
And I didn't know what that was, so I asked my roommates. I'm like, what does this mean? They're like, oh, because we download all this like Napster shit. I was like, what the fuck? I was like, you better fucking stop. That's how I learned about BitTorrent. And I was like, he was like, that's the thing I got running on your computer all the time. I was like, you motherfucker. That thing's like, not only is it slowing down. But then he's like, but that's how I get, you know, your movies that's and your, and your songs that you want. I was like, oh, okay.
I was going to say, you were going to just say, oh, well, fuck it. Okay. All that's right, how cool. I got my movies. Like, shit.
Oh,
I didn't know he's robbing them from people in Brazil or something.
That's funny as hell.
But this is how I got episode one.
Yeah. That shit is funny. Napster.
Kev, you would love my workstation here now. I've like had like a pencil explosion where I emptied out all my pencils and inks and everything, and all my stuff is just, it's just lying around in this piles. So I reach my hand out and I grab like any number of pencils and inking pens. It's like it's a heaven on earth.
That's the best.
There you go.
That is the best, though. That's the best feeling in the world.
I do like to be organized, but you know,
it's like art porn when all your shit is all over the fucking table and you just like, that's nice, man. That's nice.
No, you just have it. You have it strategically placed.
Nah. Right? I like my favorite moment is like when I have the drop cloth down on the floor. I have a piece of paper or a canvas, and I get some spray paints for the background. Then I start adding like little bits and pieces with different like tools. And then there's a moment where I gotta leave to get something from upstairs, and I come back downstairs, and I stand back over the piece.
And you forgot why you even went upstairs.
There's just a fucking mess of just art supplies around it. That's that moment right there, where I can like continue, is the fucking greatest moment ever. Because now I'm standing over the piece. I'm standing over the piece. I'm looking at it, and there's all these options of just supplies that are already open, ready to be used. And it's like, oh, it's like freedom. It feels like freedom. Then you just pick it up. Pick this up. It's the best, man. It's the best.
Been waiting a long time for this moment.
Yeah, it's the best. Ain't better than that shit.
Oh. We got Senator Palpatine in the house.
No, better than that shit.
What then? Okay, babe. Okay, guys, look, I'm wrapping the first glass up right now.
Oh, are you rolling up your first joint?
Rolling up your first day tonight. Nice. Do that shit.
First one's gonna go in the package already.
Do that shit.
Play that motherfucker, please.
Yeah, you got to send that MP3 to Mundo, man, so you can use it as a ringtone.
Yeah, definitely, for sure, man.
That would be the shit.
Yes, and I'm gonna put it on Anthony's.
I want it too, because like when Mundo,
if he calls me in the middle of the fucking day, I'm gonna say it's Anthony. And Kevin, you're gonna have to do yours, man. We're gonna get Kevin.
Yeah, we need the one with like the hard ups at the end, whatever Kevin calls it at the end when it hits it 10 times. Let's see.
In here, we pour whiskey.
You think how 10 seconds or maybe 15 seconds with just those cymbal hits.
Right.
Oh, yo,
all right, so we got the first one. First one is repped, fellas. Going in the box tonight.
Nice.
Oh, he did, huh? Oh, I'm proud of that. He did?
You see how George Lucas flat out said in trilogy.
Hell yeah.
It's not canon. Cool.
That's great news, Primal. Thank you for bringing me that news. That made my day. Seriously. I have like a 10% depression every day. The only reason is because of those movies. you're lifting this sad sentiments with that news.
Told you Primal knows it all, bro. Primal needs a fucking blog. You got a blog?
I mean, we all kind of knew that already.
I want to subscribe.
You know, I think we all knew that those movies weren't legit. Like, you know, where there's smoke, there's fire. Like, I could smell that from a mile away that was not legit.
Shit was just weird. Mm-hmm. It was weird. They were all just fucking
weird. They wrote that by the seat of their pants. So it was just garbage.
Okay. So here's one for you guys. The Fantastic Four. Very first movie that came out.
Yeah. I actually liked it.
Okay. I think it's way better than the other remakes that came out.
What other remakes?
The other remakes of the Fantastic Four,
of course.
No, I liked it, man. I'm not gonna lie. I love that shit.
Did you
I said that like Jessica Alba, like at the height, like after fucking Alias, they got Jessica Alba. Are you kidding me? Like they had this fucking Chris, Chris Evans, even before Captain America.
Yeah.
And that's their first character. Like the Flame On is their fucking first character, dude. Like their first ever character in Human Torch. That's something special.
They look cool as fuck.
And he pulled it off.
They should have recognized a little more though what they had, because like they had the first Marvel character. Did they take it seriously enough? I don't know. But
who's the first Marvel character?
The Human Torch, bro.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That's the first Marvel character, bro.
Yeah. Remember that first Marvel comic of him stepping through the safe door? That's like the first fucking superhero ever.
Ever knew.
You know what's crazy is that they actually have contracts to where the actors from that do Marvel movies cannot go and do DC movies. Character movies.
Oh. I believe that.
Well, Chris Evans like got underneath the radar early on, because me and Kevin would go see anything that was superhero related. We went to see a movie called Push.
Push was the shit.
2009, and Chris Evans starred in it as like some guy who had telekinesis, and he could push things with his mind or something like that. He could maybe push thoughts into people's mind. I forget how it went. And it was supposed to be like a trilogy. They kind of planned for this is going to be like a trilogy, but they never made any more. It's just a one.
Was it was that DC or Marvel?
I don't. It was just like
standalone flick.
It's like a rant. It's just like a script that they pulled out of their ass. It had like Dakota Fanning was like she was like the mega mutant in it, where she I guess had the best powers. They were all after her.
I'd have to check that out.
It was good.
Kev, I don't know if that was the time we were in the theater though, where I think it was that movie where we ate like a cookie. And it was too much for both of us. We couldn't breathe, and we had to like step outside.
That was Watchmen.
I was like, Kev, I can't breathe. He's like, me neither. I was like, what do we do?
Yeah. So we watched Watchmen, right?
Yeah.
Ant was like, yo, I got the best seats. I'm like, what seats? So I'm following him. He goes all the way to the fucking last row and shit. I'm like, yo, why are you in the last row? He's like, yo, in the middle, there's no lights here. And we see everybody, so we're going to see the shooter. I was like, what the fuck are you talking about, bro? I'm like, what? So then we fucking eat cookies and shit. And then it gets to the scene where Dr. Manhattan goes to Mars and he builds that like glass, like clock fucking castle.
Yeah.
So that shit is constructed and like, I felt like I was following every inch of construction. Like I saw every cog that he built. And I'm looking at that shit. Right. I had to like shake my head, like, what the fuck? And I look at Ant, and he was already looking at me like, I know, bro. That was the point. And that was the point where we were like, yo, like, this is too much, right? And he was just like, I gotta go outside.
I think at one point we said to each other, like, yo, Dr. Manhattan has veins. And we couldn't take it anymore. We're like, that's it. It's over.
We're like, yo, some graphic fucking like artist gave him a dick. Why? Why they give him a dick? And they put like little sparkly bits in it. I'm like, what the fuck is this? I was like, this movie's too much. And then remember when he was reassembling himself and like he would show up in the cafeteria as like just like a, just like a, like a That was too much. That was too much. And then I remember this clearly. I was kind of like coming back to normal. I think I'm myself now. So I'm watching the movie. I'm like, this movie's fucking crazy. And then it gets to the point where Rorschach is like takes off his mask and he's like, fucking do it. And he just fucking explodes. He just
popped into it.
That was another scene. I was just like, like, what the fuck? This movie has to end. That movie was too much.
I think they should have played that song just to swing in while he's doing all that shit.
Yo, that movie was fucking crazy, man. It fucked me up. It really fucked me up. To me, it just had
a little bit of hard time where that dude is just trying to rape that lady superhero, you know?
Oh, that was bad.
You know, to me, it kind of brought the whole movie down from that point because it's supposed to be a superhero movie, but you got, you know, this.
Well, it's like reality. It's like, what if superheroes were real?
No. I don't want to say.
I know. It's more or less reality.
The fact that they showed like devices and the bullshit side of like the superheroes themselves. Like, you know what I mean? Like, they were superheroes, but they were just That's why I like the boys.
I get it.
The boys,
because like some people are going to be rapists, so it just makes sense that, you know, you'd have a superhero in there that was a rapist. And especially when they have the power, it's like, you know, they say like absolute power corrupts absolutely. So you have like someone with power, and then it's so whatever like deep recesses, like let's say they would have grew up and become a plumber that just wouldn't have raped anybody, just would have been a plumber. But then like now they're like some big old like superhero dude that can like choke people. And then the next thing they're like, oh, well, I'll just take what I want.
Vader. Yeah,
true. It's fucking true, man. Like, what the fuck? It's crazy, man.
I even went to see that movie back in the day.
I like Rorschach, though.
Yeah, me too. They had the perfect actor portraying Rorschach. Perfect.
They did, right? They really did. I mean, he played it like, he was spot on, dude. Spot on.
I thought the dude who played Dr. Manhattan like before he turned into Blue was also really, really good for that role.
Yeah, like, he was.
He was a shit.
I was waiting for him to start singing Blue Dabbity-Dolly.
And the other dude who is like Night Owl, he became like, I think like he's like one of my favorite actors right now.
That dude like, is a shit.
He was like the husband in the, what's those movies, Kevin?
Horror movies.
It starts with a C.
Conjuring.
And he was in a couple of those. I really liked him in that. And he was in those Annabelle movies too. And I think
he became a horror flick actor.
Yeah, he was good.
And then he was also in Aquaman. He was like the brother of Aquaman. He was good.
Mm-hmm. He was.
He kind of like evolved too. Like he kind of like looked a certain way in that like Night Owl. And then like by the time we got to like Aquaman, are those both DC? Is that both DC? Like Watchmen is DC?
They're both DC.
Probably.
Yeah, sure.
He said,
Mama said, knock you out.
So why not? If you were a huge god, I imagine that many people would just be naked, cut, screw it.
Precisely.
That's crazy.
You know what was a great show, too? I heard it went sour, but for a season or two, that show called Legion.
Yeah,
it's like
yeah.
Professor X's son, and that shit was out of this world weird. It was like a mindscape adventure. Like, this powers of this creatures in the show, the people in the show, were like all mind-bending and crazy. Like, they end up spending,
I never
like,
got to see it. Mundo was amazing.
Like, it's hard. Like, it's probably easy enough to find, but for someone like me who's like, you know, half an idiot, like I had to like find it through the channel. It's like on, it was like FX. It was like an FX show. So I bought FX. Like I bought like PlayStation TV to get fucking FX at the time to watch this. But
it's I think it's on. You could Netflix find it on
YouTube
right
or something. Maybe it's on Netflix. Maybe it's on some thing, Hulu or something. But I heard it, I heard like in the third season it didn't go well. Like for like the show took a turn. But and the first season or two was really, really interesting because I think they only have like 8 episodes a season. But this shit goes off the deep end as far as like a mind fuck for the audience plus the characters. Like the characters are just like controlled by other characters because they have mind powers and they start to realize and like what the fuck, and then it's really, really weird show, but done really nicely.
Well, I'm definitely gonna have to check that out.
Yeah, it's got like, you know, the X-Men connection. So like in the show Legion, in the logo, you'll see like the O is like the X-Men symbol because like Legion is like Professor X's son or something like that.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, the animated Spawn show. I bought the DVD when that first came out. That was good.
Yeah, they came out good. Yeah, it came out good.
That was nice. And Todd, I think
Todd McFarlane was on top of his game on that shit, dude.
That's amazing. Yeah, I think before you got here, Mundo, we're talking about Todd McFarlane and Spawn and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And how like they started Image Comics, and then Spawn had this cartoon. And they also had, I think they have a newer cartoon, like in the vein of that Iron Man thing you were showing before. Like, I think there's new art for like a new cartoon. But this is, I think, the animated Spawn show that Prime was talking about. It's that one from like the 90s.
Yeah.
Maybe it's from like year 2000, something like that.
Well, it was so graphic. It was so graphic. They had to keep it on HBO.
Yeah. But they had really good voice acting in it. And, scary too, like that clown thing that like I think John Leguizamo played it in the movie, if I'm not mistaken.
Like John Leguizamo scary. he actually did pretty good in the Spawn movie, man. I liked him.
He was good.
Cause I mean just a total psychotic, you know? And he played it really well. You know, I noticed I haven't seen John Leguizamo in too many things these days.
Nah, he's done.
Is he?
I just saw his name come up on something the other day.
I mean,
something.
I've been using the iPad too much, bro. I'm trying to draw and I fucked up and I tapped it.
I do that. I double tap to get rid of a line and it doesn't work on paper.
I was like, what the fuck? I was like, yeah, I was confused for a minute. Like, wait, I was like, wait, it didn't undo it. Holy shit, that's scary, bro. That's bad news. Jesus Christ. That's so fucking stupid. Yeah, it was just habit. Like, I made a line that it makes sense. I'm drawing. And I stared at it for a second, like, what?
Idiota.
Dude, that Hacksmith is making I think a full-on Iron Man suit right now.
Who?
Hacksmith.
He's making an Iron Man suit?
A full-on Iron Man suit.
Are you gonna wear it, Mundo?
Me? Hell no, I'm too fucking fat, man. Shit. I'd like to. That'd be fun as shit. Sick. That'd be funny as shit. Hell yeah. Be doing Mach 2 cross. Oh my God. I'd be able to get over there to Jersey and back over here in a few minutes.
Well, my karate teacher was showing me today some YouTube video of the SR-72.
What's that?
SR-72 Blackbird, bitch. Ooh. Not the SR-71. The fucking SR-72. 50 years later. The SR-71 did Mach 3. This motherfucker does Mach 6. They doubled that shit.
Yeah, they doubled it. Dude.
They say the air goes by it so fast that this shit is like, it's as hot as, I forget what they said. It's like hotter than fire. When it's flying so fast that the friction of the air hitting it, is like would be devastating. Like they say the original SR-71 had panels that were like, if you looked at it up close, you'd be like, oh, they're not fitting together right. They're like far apart. They're inches apart from each other, all the panels on the body. But as it flew, it got so hot that that shit expanded and then fit together perfectly when that shit's going like 3,000 miles an hour. Oh, wow. Isn't that amazing? They did that in 1966. Imagine what they're doing today. They call it the SR-72, and they got pictures of it flying around. It goes so high and so fast that, like, I don't know.
Did you ever play Mech Warriors?
Yeah, I think I did.
It won't be long before we actually have, well, because people are already working on it. We're going to end up having Mech Warrior suits pretty soon.
No, we don't need the suits. You know, we need like the Terminator, like skeleton type things that are Terminators. I always thought if we had like 12 or 13 of those Terminators, right? And they're just like remote control. And what you do is you go get the 13-year-old boys that play the video games and you sit them like they're in Ohio or something. Like you sit them in Ohio and they're on a fucking computer. And then the like they're controlling them. Maybe they take shifts because you can't like work kids like too hard, I guess. So they're doing shifts. and the Terminators, you don't even need to fly them. Just have them like walk across the ocean floor to wherever we go, and then they come out, and the people are like, "What the fuck?" And then like they just like lay waste, but they're really 13-year-old kids back at home in Ohio controlling them.
My God, no, we just invaded another country. Yeah, but you don't want to do that to a kid, man. It'll screw up.
No, but you just tell them, like, this is a video game. Nobody's getting hurt. And they're like, oh, great. I'm going to get the high score. And you're like, yeah, bitch, get those Russians.
Yeah, but what happens later when they actually find out that it's real people they're killing?
That's a fucking movie, bro. They did that. This story's been written already.
Oh, it's called War Games?
No, it's called... I forgot what it's called, but this is a movie. But, like, the kids, because the kids are like... I forgot why they use kids, but the kids were doing it.
Ender's Game.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I saw that series. Okay. That's true. They did make that movie.
Yeah. Harrison Ford was the main character.
Yeah.
It is Harrison Ford, right?
And Asa Butterfield, or however you say the name.
He wasn't, for sure, he wasn't on Solo there.
He was in that shit?
He was like the admiral or the captain. He was like running everything. Mm-hmm. He was tricking everybody.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Mm-hmm. Especially the young boy. He was basically brainwashing him, thinking, you know, hey, we need you to do this. Because if you don't do this, they're going to come back and kill us.
Yeah.
And they weren't even come close to doing that.
Nah, they were.
They were just defending themselves.
They weren't even fucking with them.
Oh yeah, I remember now.
They didn't even care.
Yeah, they were just defending themselves. And
like, yo, we're not fucking with you. We're just here chilling. Like, give me a break, bro.
If you haven't seen Spawn's real. Gameplay trailer in Mortal Kombat. Watch that. Oh my God, it's so good. I think I've seen that because I've been watching a lot of the Mortal Kombat trailers for the new Mortal Kombat game. And it oh my God, they're so fucking hilarious, dude. They got all these different characters. They even have Arnold Schwarzenegger as the Terminator, right?
Oh yeah.
And they got Terminator, they got RoboCop, they got Spawn, they've got all kinds of other people. You know, in Mortal Kombat, I'm all like, oh my gosh. And so I think it's the Terminator and RoboCop going at it, right? And RoboCop goes, I think we've done this before. So they start fighting each other, right? And then it cuts off to where one of them wins and they start doing one of those fatalities, right? So RoboCop I mean, not RoboCop. What do you call it? The Terminator takes his shotgun and blows RoboCop right in the face, man. Oh. Brain splatter from the back of his head. He's falling backwards, and then he grabs him and does all kinds of other shit for the fatality, right?
Fucking Murphy.
It's wicked. It is too wicked. You will not
check this out because I think it had some warning in the beginning of it. So if we get booted out of this show, go check out Albatross Junction on IndieGogo. There's a pre-launch link in the description of this video. Also, go check out albatrossjunction.com if you want to check out some concept art that we've done in the past. And every single Wednesday, we do live shows where we're drawing Albatross Junction in various stages, colors, pencils, inks. Mundo is usually here. Me and Kevin are here drawing.
Yo, you want to see what I didn't get that fucking far, but you want to see where the fuck I'm at real quick?
Absolutely.
Yes. Yes.
It's not much, but like this is the top panel.
Oh, dude, that's cool, man.
See, Alba's holding a remote and shit. Then it'll be him here.
And there you go.
This is what he's gonna say: drop that, or else blah blah blah. And then this panel here is gonna have her hand clicking the button. Click. I'm gonna have like a click. You know what I'm saying? And his eyes are gonna be fucking wide open. They're like, oh fuck. And then I got some real cool shit coming down here. I got
because he's like he gets hurt by her hitting the button or something like that. Is that why you say his eyes go?
Yeah, he makes his blood boil. I love it. Yeah.
It was all in the click, damn it.
All in the click. The click is gonna be amazing.
The click is gonna be amazing. Yeah.
It's good shit.
Kevin said. It's gonna be, it's listen good. To Kevin. He knows what the shit he talks about.
Oh.
There you go.
Together, we can purge the 10.
Looking good. Only looks like the toy. They must have like got the toy.
I want to play this game. I want to play it.
Oh, he hit him with his fucking cape and his chains. Oh my god. Yo, he did so much before he put a hand on him.
Oh.
Fuck is that Indiana Jones? Oh, that's what I just said.
He was fighting.
Oh, Spawn, he got. Oh my god, he is a.
So it looks like Spawn has his powers.
No, yeah, this is fire. Oh, this is fire.
Spawn is perfect for Mortal Kombat.
Yeah, well, he's basically Scorpion. He's basically Scorpion.
He's like more like the devil than Scorpion.
Oh my god. Oh, and he got pissed.
look, it's a different Spawn. It's a different Spawn with like different boots and shit.
It's the third one. It's the third. The second one was different too. Oh.
Nice Jeez. Kick.
Oh, hit him with a number 12, man.
Oh my god.
Oh, Leo. Oh, like.
Oh my god.
Oh.
Oh.
Oh. Oh. That wasn't the finish? Holy shit.
It wasn't finished. That was just the beginning of it.
Oh, he's getting ravaged, dude. He got eviscerated.
Oh, he took skin off. Oh. Oh.
That's awful.
Yeah, I like it.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, that's fire.
Well, now.
That is too that cool. Is fire. It's funny. He got a little fire. Hot. He got a little hot under the collar. You thought Scorpion was warm, but shit.
That was fire. I
like don't choke on your aspirations. All right. So I think we're going to roll out of here.
Yeah.
Kevin, that was pretty awesome to see that. Was that the first page that you started from issue two, or is it the second?
Yeah, it's the first page I started. So I'm going to do that in the next one.
Cool. Yeah, good. I'm working on 30, six, but I have like, I still got like three or four more to go. I don't know. Every time I turn, it's three or four more. Are you adding them? Is somebody adding them?
What do you mean?
Are you adding pages? Every time I turn around, I have three or four more pages to draw.
Not
when is it going to be zero?
He's trying to keep me busy, man.
I want to get to the inking and the coloring. I'd sign up for that job. For that job.
Primal!
When he fights the Joker, he goes, I fucking hate clowns. yeah, that's going to be great. Thanks so much for being here, Primal. We're going to see you probably, on Monday for Mundo Monday? What day is it today? It's Wednesday. Yeah. So Mundo Monday is coming up. We'll probably be here that night around 10 o'clock working on Albatross Junction. In the meantime, go check out our IndieGogo. It's in the description. And just drop in your email. We'll get you two extra trading cards and another poster in addition to the poster you're going to get for getting Albatross Junction when it is released in 2021. And I think that's all I have to say. Kevin, you want to say anything before we roll out of here?
Nah, man, I'm just going to keep cracking away on these pencils, man.
Coming out good. Thanks for doing that. Thanks for being here, Mundo. You got anything you want to...
Yeah, appreciate being here, guys. It's always a it's always a blast being here, man. Appreciate y'all.
Yeah, hell yeah, hell yeah. Looking forward to the next one.
Yeah, that was a lot of pretty soon we're gonna have some shirts and stuff. So we'll see where that goes with those shirt designs we did at the top of the episode.
Yeah.
We will remember and try to order those.
I saved the one I did.
Yeah, I want to get that one for Christmas. I'm gonna get Mike one, get Mundo one. Well, I want to get Mundo one that says El Mundo's.
There you go.
That's the one I want to do, the El Mundo's one.
yeah,
dude. Definitely, for sure.
It's definitely the one I want to do.
Maybe we'll work on that a little more on Mundo Monday.
All right, man. Let's do it. All right.
Have a good night, everybody.
All right, fellas.
Later, guys.
Go on.